Now, in similarity, we will see next point, basic proportionality theorem. Now here theorem, if a line parallel to a side of a triangle intersects the remaining sides in two distinct points, that is P and Q, then the line divides the sides in the same proportion. That is, we have to prove this theorem. Now here, first we write given. We have given in triangle ABC, line L is parallel to side BC, which intersects and intersects sides AB and side AC in points P and Q respectively. This is given. Now to prove, we have to prove AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. Construction, draw segment PC and segment QB. Now first write down given. In triangle ABC, line L parallel to side BC, line L parallel to side BC and intersects the sides AB and AC in points P and Q respectively. This is we have given. Now we have to prove. AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. Construction, draw segment PC and segment QB. Proof. Now here write down. In proof, here to prove. Now from figure, triangle APQ and triangle PQB have same height. Triangle APQ and triangle PQB have same height. Since their bases are on same line, therefore these two triangles have same height. Therefore, by by the ratio of areas of two triangles. Ratio of areas of two triangles. We can write this as area of triangle APQ. Area of triangle APQ divided by area of triangle PQB. Area of triangle PQB is equal to, now heights are equal, therefore they are in proportion of their bases, that is AP upon PB is equal to AP upon PB. This is number one. Also, triangle APQ and triangle PQC have same height. Also, triangle APQ and triangle PQC have same height, therefore by ratio of areas of two triangles area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQC, APQ divided by area of triangle PQC is equal to, now heights are equal, therefore they are in proportion of their bases, AQ upon QC. AQ upon QC. This is number two. Now, triangle PQB and triangle PQC, they have, these two triangles have same base PQ and they lies in the, in between parallel lines. Therefore, their areas are equal and triangle PQB and triangle PQC having same base, PQ, and they lie in between two parallel lines, therefore their areas are equal. Area of triangle PQB is equal to area of triangle PQC. This is number 3. Now, from equations 1, 2 and 3, here numerators are equal, area of triangle APQ, and from 3 their denominator also equal. Therefore, write down from equations 1, 2 and 3. We write this as, here left hand sides are equal, area of triangle APQ divided by area of triangle PQB is equal to area of triangle APQ divided by area of triangle PQC. Therefore, from 1 and 2, value of this left hand side is AP upon PB and right hand side is AQ upon QC. Therefore, from equations 1 and 2, AP upon PB is equal to value of this is AQ upon QC. This is the proof of this theorem. Now we will see the property of converse of basic proportionality theorem. Now here in triangle PQR we have given converse of basic proportionality theorem. We know that basic proportionality theorem, if ST parallel to QR, then by basic proportionality theorem PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR. Now its converse part, that is, if PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR, then ST parallel to QR. Now if in triangle, in triangle PQR, PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR. Therefore, by converse of basic proportionality theorem, segment ST parallel to side QR. Segment ST parallel to side QR. This is the converse of basic proportionality theorem. Now, next point. Property of an angle bisector of a triangle. Now, from this figure, if segment BD is the bisector of angle ABC, then by property of angle bisector of a triangle, AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DC. Now, write down, if in triangle ABC, segment BD is the bisector of angle ABC, therefore, by property of angle bisector of a triangle, triangle bisector of a triangle. We can write this as AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DC. AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DC. This is the angle bisector property. Now next point is property of three parallel lines and their transversal. Now from this figure, if line AX parallel to line BY parallel to line CZ and their trans L and M, line L and line M are their transversals, then by property of three parallel lines we can write this as AB upon BC is equal to XY upon YZ. Write down, if line AX parallel to line BY parallel to line CZ and line L and M are its transversals therefore by property of three parallel lines now we can write this as AB upon BC is equal to XY upon YZ. That is, AB upon BC is equal to XY upon YZ. Now we will see some problems. Practice set 1.2. Now first problem is, given below are some triangles and lengths of line segments. Identify in which figures ray PM is the bisector of angle QPR. Now here we will see, in first figure we have given triangle PQR. In this triangle we have given values, PQ is 7, PR is 3, QM is 3.5 and RM is 1.5. We have to show whether ray PM is the bisector of angle QPR. Now that is, we have to, if QP upon PR is equal to QM upon MR, then this ray is the bisector of angle QPR. Otherwise it is not a bisector. Now we will solve first problem. Now in triangle PQR, now first we find value of PQ upon PR is equal to PQ is 7 divided by PR is 3. 7 upon 3, this is number 1. And QM upon MR, here larger number is in numerator, therefore take larger number, that is greater number, that is QM. QM upon MR is equal to 3.5 divided by 1.5. Now here this decimal point get cancelled, is equal to 35 upon 15 dividing by 5 3 7 is equal to 7 upon 3. This is number 2. Now here right hand sides of equation 1 and 2 are equal, that is 7 upon 3, therefore its left hand side is also equal. Therefore from 1 and 2 PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. That is, these ratios are equal. PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. Therefore, by property of angle bisector of a triangle, by converse of property of angles bisectors of a triangle, Ray PM is the bisector of angle QPR. This is first. Now second, now in this figure we have given in triangle PQR, we have given PR is 10, PQ is 9, RM is 4 and MQ is 3.6. Now by similar method we can solve this. Now first write down, in triangle PQR. Now first we find PQ upon PR is equal to, value of PQ is 9 divided by PR is 10. This is number 1. And here smaller number is in numerator, therefore QM or MQ, QM upon MR is equal to 3.6 divided by 4. Now here we can write this as, now remove this decimal, that is we can write this 36 divided by 40. Now dividing by 4, 10, 9 is equal to 9 upon 10. This is number 2. Now we'll see here right hand sides of equations 1 and 2 are equal, therefore its left hand side also equal. Therefore from 1 and 2 we can write left hand sides are equal, that is PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. Here ratios PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. Therefore, by converse of property of angle bisectors of a triangle ray PM is the bisector of angle QPR. Ray QM is the bisector of angle QPR. Now we will see second example. Now in triangle QPR, in triangle PQR, PM is equal to, we have given PM is 15, PQ is 25, PR is 20, and NR is 8. State whether line NM is parallel to side QR, RQ. Give reason. Now, by using basic probabilistic proportionality theorem, we can solve this problem. Now, first we have to find value of PN. Now, in triangle PQR, here P dash N dash R, therefore we can write PN plus NR is equal to PR. Therefore put values, value of PN is, we have to find value of PN plus NR is 8 is equal to PR is 20. Therefore PN is equal to 20 minus 8. Therefore PN is equal to 12. Value of PN is 12. Now similarly we have to find value of MQ, and P dash M dash Q, therefore PM plus MQ is equal to PR. Therefore value of PM is 15 plus MQ is equal to PR is 25. Therefore MQ is equal to 25 minus 15. Therefore MQ is equal to 25 minus 15 is 10. Now we know value of PN, NR, PM and MQ. Now we find the ratio. Now first ratio PN upon NR is equal to, value of PN is 12 divided by NR is 8. dividing by 4 Pn upon Nr, that is Pn is 12 divided by Nr is 8, dividing by 4, 2, 3 is equal to 3 upon 2. This is number 1. And Pm upon Mq, Pm upon Mq is equal to, now value of Pm, Pm is 15, value of Pm 15 divided by Mq is 10, Mq is 10, dividing by 5, 2, 3 is equal to 3 upon 2. This is number 2. Now from 1 and 2, therefore from 1 and 2, here right hand sides are equal, therefore its left hand side also equal. From 1 and 2, Pn upon Nr is equal to Pm upon Mq. That is, Pn upon Nr is equal to Pm upon Mq. Therefore, by converse of basic proportionality theorem, line Nm is parallel to side Rq. Therefore, by converse of basic proportionality theorem, we can write this as, in short, BPT also. By converse of basic proportionality theorem, line Nm, parallel to side Rq. This is the answer. Now third problem. In trapezium ABCD, side AB parallel to side PQ parallel to side DC. We have given values, AP is equal to 15, PD is equal to 12, QC is equal to 14. We have to find value of BQ. Now first write down given, in trapezium ABCD, side AB parallel to side PQ parallel to side DC. These three sides are parallel, therefore by property of three parallel lines, we can write this as AP upon PD is equal to BQ upon QC. Now put its values. Value of AP is 15. 15 divided by PD is 12 is equal to BQ. We have to find BQ, divided by QC is 14. Therefore, you can write this for BQ. BQ is equal to, now taking cross multiplication, 15 into 14 divided by 12. Now here dividing by 3, 4, 5. Dividing by 2, 2, 7. Is equal to 7 into 5, 35 divided by 2. Therefore, value of BQ is equal to 17.5. This is value of BQ. Thank you.